Bello H58 Kiowa. The Bello H58 Kiowa is a family of single-engine, single-rotor, military helicopters used for observation, utility, and direct fire support. Bell Helicopter manufactured the OH-58 for the United States Army based on its Model 206A Jet Ranger helicopter. The OH-58 was in continuous U.S. Army service from 1969 to 2017, when it was replaced in this role by the Boeing AH-64 Apache. The latest model, the OH-58D Kiowa Warrior, is primarily operated in an armed reconnaissance role in support of ground troops. The OH-58 has been exported to Austria, Canada, Croatia, the Dominican Republic, Taiwan, Saudi Arabia, and Greece. It has also been produced under license in Australia. On October 14, 1960, the United States Navy asked 25 helicopter manufacturers on behalf of the Army for proposals for a light observation helicopter, LOH. Bell Helicopter entered the competition along with 12 other manufacturers, including Hiller Aircraft and Hughes Tool Company, Aircraft Division. Bell submitted the D-250 design, which would be designated as the H-4. On May 19, 1961, Bell and Hiller were announced as winners of the design competition. Bell developed the D-250 design into the Model 206 aircraft, with the H-04 designation being changed to H-4A in 1962. And produced 5 prototype aircraft for the Army's test and evaluation phase. The first prototype flew on December 8, 1962. The O-4A also became known as the Ugly Duckling in comparison to the other contending aircraft. Following a fly-off of the Bell, Hughes and Fairchild Hiller prototypes, the Hughes OH-6 Cayuse was selected in May 1965. When the O-4A was rejected by the Army, Bell went about solving the problem of marketing the aircraft. In addition to the image problem, the helicopter lacked cargo space and only provided cramped quarters for the planned 3 passengers in the back. The solution was a fuselage redesign to be more sleek and aesthetic, adding of cargo space in the process. The redesigned aircraft was designated as the Model 206A, and Bell President Edwin J. Ducayette named it the Jet Ranger, denoting an evolution from the popular Model 47J Ranger. In 1967, the Army reopened the low competition for bids because Hughes Tool Company Aircraft Division could not meet the contractual production demands. Bell resubmitted for the program using the Bell 206A. Fairchild Hiller failed to resubmit their bid with the O5A, which they had successfully marketed as FH-1100. In the end, Bell underbid Hughes to win the contract, and the Bell 206A was designated as the OH-58A. Following the U.S. Army's naming convention for helicopters, the OH-58A was named Kiowa in honor of the Native American tribe. In the 1970s, the U.S. Army began evaluating the need to improve the capabilities of their scout aircraft. Anticipating the AH-64A's replacement of the venerable A-1, the Army began shopping the idea of an aerial scout program to stimulate the development of advanced technological capabilities for night vision and precision navigation equipment. The stated goals of the program included prototypes that would possess an extended target acquisition range capability, be means of a long-range stabilized optical subsystem for the observer, improved position location through use of a computerized navigation system, improved survivability by reducing oral, visual, radar, and infrared signatures, and an improved flight performance capability derived from a larger engine to provide compatibility with attack helicopters. The Army created a special task force at Fort Knox to develop the system requirements in early March 1974, and by 1975 the task force had devised the requirements for an Advanced Scout Helicopter (ASH) program. The requirements were formulated around an aircraft capable of performing in day, night, and adverse weather, and compatible with all the advanced weapons systems planned for development and fielding into the 1980s. The program was approved by the System Acquisition Review Council, and the Army prepared for competitive development to begin the next year. However, as the Army tried to get the program off the ground, Congress declined to provide funding for it in the fiscal year 1977 budget, and the ASH Project Manager's Office, PMASH, was closed on September 30, 1976. While no development occurred during the next few years, the program survived as a requirement without funding. On November 30, 1979, the decision was made to defer development of an advanced scout helicopter in favor of pursuing modification of existing airframes in the inventory as a near-term scout helicopter, NTSH, option. The development of a mast-mounted sight would be the primary focus to improve the aircraft's ability to perform reconnaissance, surveillance, and target acquisition missions while remaining hidden behind trees and terrain. Both the UH-1 and the OH-58 were evaluated as NTSH candidates, but the UH-1 was dropped from consideration due to its larger size and ease of detection. The OH-58, on the other hand, demonstrated a dramatic reduction in detectability with a mast-mounted sight, MMS. On July 10, 1980, the Army decided that the NTSH would be a competitive modification program based on developments in the commercial helicopter industry, particularly Hughes Helicopters' development of the Hughes 500D, which provided significant improvements over the OH-6. The Army's decision to acquire the NTSH resulted in the Army Helicopter Improvement Program, AHIP. Both Bell Helicopter and Hughes Helicopters redesigned their Scout aircraft to compete for the contract. Bell offered a more robust version of the OH-58 in their Model 406 aircraft, and Hughes offered an upgraded version of the OH-6. On September 21, 1981, Bell Helicopter Textron was awarded a development contract. The first prototype flew on October 6, 1983, and the aircraft entered service in 1985 as the OH-58D. Initially intended for attack, cavalry, and artillery roles, the Army only approved a low initial production level and confined the role of the OH-58D to field artillery observation. The Army also directed that a follow-on test be conducted to further evaluate the aircraft due to perceived deficiencies. On April 1, 1986, the Army formed a task force at Fort Rucker, Alabama, to remedy deficiencies in the AHIP. In 1988, the Army had planned to discontinue the OH-58D and focus on the LHX. However, Congress approved $138 million to expand the program, calling for the AHIP to operate with the Apache as a hunter-slash-killer team. The AHIP would locate targets and the Apache would destroy them in a throwback to the traditional OH-58-AH-1 relationship. The Secretary of the Army directed instead that the aircraft's armament systems be upgraded, based on experience with Task Force 118's performance operating armed OH-58D helicopters in the Persian Gulf in support of Operation Prime Chance, and that the aircraft be used primarily for scouting and armed reconnaissance. The armed aircraft would be known as the OH-58D Kiowa Warrior, denoting its new armed configuration. Beginning with the production of the 202nd Aircraft S/N89-0112, in May 1991, all remaining OH-58D aircraft were produced in the Kiowa Warrior configuration. In January 1992, Bell Helicopter received its first retrofit contract to convert all remaining OH-58D Kiowa helicopters to the Kiowa Warrior configuration. The OH-58D introduced the most distinctive feature of the Kiowa family, the mast-mounted sight, MMS, which resembles a beach ball perched above the radar system. The MMS by Ball Aerospace and Technologies has a gyro-stabilized platform containing a television system, TVS, a thermal imaging system, TIS, and a laser rangefinder/designator, LRF/D. These new features gave the aircraft the additional mission capability of target acquisition and laser designation and day or night, limited visibility and adverse weather. The mast-mounted sight system was developed by the McDonnell Douglas Corporation in Huntington Beach, California. Production took place primarily at facilities in Monrovia, CA. As a result of a merger with Boeing, and a later sale of the business unit, the program is currently owned and managed by DRS Technologies, with engineering support based in Cypress, California, and production support taking place in Melbourne, Florida. One distinctive feature of operational OH-58s are the knife-like extensions above and below the cockpit, which are part of the passive wire strike protection system. It can protect 90% of the frontal area of the helicopter from wire strikes that can be encountered at low altitudes by directing wires to the upper or lower blades before they can entangle the rotor blade or landing skids. The OH-58 was the first helicopter to test this system, after which the system was adopted by the U.S. Army for the OH-58 and most of their other helicopters. Major General John Norton, commanding general of the Army Aviation Materiel Command, AMCOM, received the first OH-58A Kiowa at a ceremony at Bell Helicopters Fort Worth plant in May 1969. 2 months later, on August 17, 1969, the first production OH-58A Kiowa helicopters were arriving in Vietnam, accompanied by a new equipment training team, NETT, from the Army and Bell Helicopters. Although the Kiowa production contract replaced the Loken contract with Hughes, the OH-58A did not automatically replace the OH-6A in operation. Subsequently, the Kiowa and the Cayuse would continue operating in the same theater until the end of the war. On March 27, 1970, an OH-58A Kiowa, SN-68-16785, was shot down over Vietnam, one of the first OH-58A losses of the war. The pilot, Warrant Officer Ralph Quick Jr., was flying Lieutenant Colonel Joseph Banowski Jr. as an artillery spotter. After completing a battle damage assessment for a previous fire mission, the aircraft was damaged by 51 calories, 13 millimeters, machine gun fire and crashed, killing both crew members. Approximately 45 OH-58A helicopters were destroyed during the Vietnam War due to combat losses and accidents. One of the last combat losses was of an OH-58A, SN-68-16888, from A Troop, 3rd 17th Cavalry, flown by 1st Lieutenant Thomas Nucky. On May 27, 1971, Lieutenant Nucky was also flying a battle damage assessment mission when his aircraft came under machine gun fire and exploded. Nucky and his observer, Sergeant Philip Taylor, both died in the explosion. In early 1988, it was decided that armed OH-58D, AHIP, helicopters from the 118th Aviation Task Force would be phased in to replace the CBAT, AH-6/MH-6 teams of Task Force 160th to carry out Operation Prime Chance, the escort of oil tankers during the Iran-Iraq War. On February 24, 1988, two AHIP helicopters reported to the Mobile Sea Base Wimbrown 7, and the helicopter team, CBAT team after their call sign, stationed on the barge returned to the United States. For the next few months, the AHIP helicopters on the Wimbrown 7 shared patrol duties with the CBAT team on the Hercules. Coordination was difficult, but despite frequent requests from TF-160, the CBAT team on the Hercules was not replaced by an AHIP detachment until June 1988. The OH-58D helicopter crews involved in the operation received deck landing and underwater survival training from the Navy. In November 1988, the number of OH-58D helicopters that supported Task Force 118 was reduced. However, the aircraft continued to operate from the Navy's Mobile Sea Base Hercules, the frigate Underwood, and the destroyer Connolly. OH-58D operations primarily entailed reconnaissance flights at night, and depending on maintenance requirements and ship scheduling, Army helicopters usually rotated from the Mobile Sea Base and other combatant ships to a land base every 7 to 14 days. On September 18, 1989, an OH-58D crashed during night gunnery practice and sank, but with no loss of personnel. When the Mobile Sea Base Hercules was deactivated in September 1989, all but five OH-58D helicopters redeployed to the continental United States. In 1989, Congress mandated that the Army National Guard would take part in the country's war on drugs, enabling them to aid federal, state, and local law enforcement agencies with special congressional entitlements. In response, the Army National Guard Bureau created the Reconnaissance and Aerial Interdiction Detachments, RAID, in 1992. Consisting of aviation units in 31 states with 76 specially modified OH-58A helicopters to assume the reconnaissance/interdiction role in the fight against illegal drugs. During 1994, 24 states conducted more than 1,200 aerial counter-drug reconnaissance and interdiction missions, conducting many of these missions at night. Eventually, the program was expanded to cover 32 states and consisting of 116 aircraft, including dedicated training aircraft at the Western Army Aviation Training Site, WATS, in Marana, Arizona. The RAID program's mission has now been expanded to include the war against terrorism and supporting U.S. Border Patrol activities in support of homeland defense. The National Guard RAID Unit's area of operation, AU, is the only one in the Department of Defense that is wholly contained within the borders of the United States. During Operation Just Cause in 1989, a team consisting of an OH-58 and an AH-1 were part of the Aviation Task Force during the securing of Fort Amador in Panama. The OH-58 was fired upon by Panama Defense Force soldiers and crashed away, in the Bay of Panama. The pilot was rescued but the co-pilot died. On December 17, 1994, Army Chief Warrant Officers, CWO, David Heilman and Bobby Hall left Camp Page, South Korea on a routine training mission along the Demilitarized Zone, DMZ. Their flight was intended to be to a point known as Checkpoint 84, south of the DMZ no-fly zone, but the OH-58C Kiowa strayed nearly into the Gangwon province, inside North Korean airspace, due to errors in navigating the snow-covered, rugged terrain. The helicopter was shot down by North Korean troops and CWO Heilman was killed. CWO Hall was held captive and the North Korean government insisted that crew had been spying. 5 days of negotiations resulted in the North Koreans turning over Heilman's body to U.S. authorities. The negotiations failed to secure Hall's immediate release. After 13 days in captivity, Hall was freed on 30 December, uninjured. The United States Army has employed the OH-58D during Operation Iraqi Freedom in Iraq and Operation Enduring Freedom in Afghanistan. Due to combatant accidents, over 35 airframes have been lost, with 35 pilots killed. Their presence has also been anecdotally credited with saving lives, having been used to rescue wounded despite their small size. In Iraq, Ohio 58DS flew 72 hours per month, while in Afghanistan, they flew 80 hours per month. In 2013, Bell stated that the OH-58 had 820,000 combat hours and 90% mission capable rate. The first attempt to replace the OH-58 was the RA-66 Comanche of the Light Helicopter Experimental Program, which was canceled in 2004. Airframe age and losses led to the Armed Reconnaissance Helicopter Program to procure a new aircraft, the Bell ARH-70, which was later canceled in 2008 due to cost overruns. The third replacement effort for the OH-58 was the Armed Aerial Scout Program. Due to uncertainty in the AS program and fiscal restraints, planned retirement of the OH-58F Kiowa was extended from 2025 to 2036. The Kiowa's role as a scout aircraft was supplemented by tactical unmanned aerial vehicles, the two platforms often acting in conjunction to provide reconnaissance to expose crews to less risk. The OH-58F had the ability to control WAV's direct light or safely perform scout missions. In 2011, the Kiowa was scheduled to be replaced by the light version of the future vertical lift aircraft in the 2030s. In December 2013, the U.S. Army had 338 Kiowas in its active duty force and 30 in the Army National Guard. The Army considered retiring the Kiowa as part of a wider restructuring to cut costs and reduce the various types of helicopters in service. The analysis of alternatives, OA, for the AS program found that Kiowa operating alongside RQ-7 Shadow WAVs was the most affordable and capable solution. It also said that the AH-64E Apache Guardian was the most capable immediate solution for the scout helicopter role. It was proposed that all O-58s be divested and all Army National Guard and Army Reserve Apaches would be transferred to the active Army to serve as scouts. The Apache costs 50% more than the Kiowa to operate and requires more maintenance. Studies showed that if the Apache had been used in place of the Kiowa in Iraq and Afghanistan, total operating costs would have been $4 billion greater, but would save $1 billion per year in operating and sustainment costs. UH-60 Black Hawks would be transferred from the active fleet to reserve and guard units. The proposal aimed to retire older helicopters to save money and retain those with the greatest capabilities. The 2010 NOAA that found that Apache's team had with WAVs was the optimal choice, with a reduced service size a total of 698 Apaches could fill the role. Funds for Apache upgrades would be released from the Kiowa's termination. Media expects the O-58s to go to foreign military rather than civilian operators due higher operating costs. The Army placed 26 out of 335 OH-58Ds in non-flyable storage during 2014. In anticipation of divesting the Kiowa, the Army looked to see if other military branches, government agencies, and foreign customers would be interested in buying the aircraft. The Kiowas are considered in a good price range for foreign countries with limited resources. Bell has not yet agreed to support the helicopters if sold overseas. The Army had divested 33 OH-58Ds. By January 2016, the Army had divested all but two OH-58D squadrons, with the aircraft to finish divestiture before the end of the year. In April 2016, two Kiowa squadrons with a combined 60 helicopters were in service. In June 2016, members of 1st Squadron, 17th Cavalry Regiment, 82nd Combat Aviation Brigade, arrived in South Korea as part of the Kiowa's last deployment in U.S. Army service. In January 2017, the last Kiowa warrior performed their last live-fire maneuver before their retirement. In 2017, in response to issues with the UH-72A training helicopter transition, The U.S. Army announced that OH-58 Kiowas will continue as trainers until 2022 at Fort Rucker, Alabama. As a consequence of the 2013 Aviation Restructure Initiative, some 340 divested U.S. Army OH-58D Kiowas were made available through Excess Defense Article and Foreign Military Sales, FMS, programs. In November 2014, Croatia sent a letter of intent for the acquisition of 16 OH-58Ds. In 2016, Croatia and Tunisia became the first nations to request the helicopters, ordering 16 and 24, respectively. Croatia received the first batch of 5 OH-58s at the Zadar Zemunik Air Base on June 30, 2016. The OH-58A Kiowa is a four-place observation helicopter. The Kiowa has two-place pilot seating, although the controls in the left seat are designed to be removed to carry a passenger up front. During its Vietnam development, it was fitted with the M134 minigun, a 7.62mm electrically operated machine gun. The Australian Army leased 8 OH-58A helicopters in 1971 in Vietnam for 8 months. A total of 74 OH-58A helicopters were delivered to the Canadian Armed Forces as Co-58A and later redesignated CH-136 Kiowa. As many as 12 surplus Kiowas were sold to the Dominican Republic Air Force, and others sold privately in Australia. In 1978, OH-58A aircraft began to be converted to the same engine and dynamic components as the OH-58C. And, in 1992, 76 OH-58A were modified with Anatar engine upgrade, a thermal imaging system, a communications package for law enforcement, enhanced navigational equipment and high skid gear as part of Army National Guard's, ARNG, counter-drug raid program. The U.S. Army retired its last OH-58A in November 2017. The OH-58B was an export version for the Austrian Air Force. The Australian government also procured the OH-58A for the Australian Army and Royal Australian Navy as the CACCA-32. Produced under contract in Australia by Commonwealth Aircraft Corporation, the CA-32 is the equivalent of the 206B1, upgraded engine and longer rotor blades. The first 12 of 56 were built in the U.S. then partially disassembled and shipped to Australia where they were reassembled. Helicopters in the naval fleet were retired in 2000. Equipped with a more robust engine, the OH-58C was supposed to solve many issues and concerns regarding the Kiowa's power. In addition to the upgraded engine, the OH-58C had unique IR suppression systems mounted on its turbine exhaust. Early C models featured flat panel windscreens as an attempt to reduce glint from the sun, which could give away the aircraft's location to an enemy. The windscreens had a negative effect of limiting the forward view of the crew, a previous strength of the original design. The aircraft was also equipped with a larger instrument panel, roughly a third bigger than the OH-58A panel, which held larger flight instruments. The panel was also equipped with night vision goggle, NVG, compatible cockpit lighting. The lights inside the aircraft are modified to prevent them from interfering with the aircrew's use of NVGs. OH-58C aircraft were also the first U.S. Army Scout helicopter to be equipped with the IN/APR-39 radar detector, a system which allowed the crew to know when there were anti-aircraft radar systems in proximity to the aircraft. Some OH-58C aircraft were armed with two AIM-92 Stingers. These aircraft are sometimes referred to as OH-58C/S, the S referring to the Stinger installation. Called Air-to-Air Stinger, ATAS, the weapon system was intended to provide an air defense capability. As of November 2017, the OH-58C is the only variant of the Kiowa still in active service of the U.S. Army, utilized as a training aircraft. The OH-58D, Bell Model 406, was the result of the Army Helicopter Improvement Program, AHIP. An upgraded transmission and engine gave the aircraft power it needed for nap-of-the-earth flight profiles, and a four-bladed main rotor made it much quieter than the two-bladed OH-58C. The OH-58D introduced the distinctive mast-mounted sight, MMS, above the rotor system, and a mixed-glass cockpit, with traditional instruments identified as standby for emergency use. The Bell 406CS Combat Scout was based on the OH-58D, sometimes referred to as the MH-58D. 15 aircraft were sold to Saudi Arabia. A roof-mounted Saab Heli tow sight system was opted for in place of the MMS. The 406CS also had detachable weapon hardpoints on each side. The AH-58D was an OH-58D version operated by Task Force 118, 4th Squadron, 17th Cavalry, and modified with armament in support of Operation Prime Chance. The weapons and fire control systems would become the basis for the Kiowa Warrior. AH-58D is not an official DoD aircraft designation, but is used by the Army in reference to these aircraft. The Kiowa Warrior, sometimes referred to by its acronym KW, is the armed version of the OH-58D Kiowa. The main difference that distinguishes the Kiowa Warrior from the original AHIP aircraft is a universal weapons pylon found mounted on both sides of the aircraft. These pylons are capable of carrying combinations of AGM-114 Hellfire missiles, air-to-air Stinger, ATAS, missiles, 7-shot Hydra 70 rocket pods, and an M296.50 caliber machine gun. The standard of performance for aerial gunnery from an OH-58D is to achieve at least one hit out of 70 shots fired at a wheeled vehicle away. The Kiowa Warrior upgrade also includes improvements in available power, navigation, communication and survivability, as well as modifications to improve the aircraft's deployability. The OH-58F is the designation for an upgrade of the OH-58D. The Cockpit and Sensor Upgrade Program, CASUP, features a nose-mounted targeting and surveillance system in addition to the OH-58D's mast-mounted sensor. The OS-53 Common Sensor Payload, CSP, includes an advanced infrared camera, color electro-optical camera, and image intensifier. It is expected to improve flight performance by 1-2% through weight and drag reductions. Cockpit upgrades include the control and display subsystem version 5, for more processing and storage power, 3-color multifunction displays, and dual independent advanced moving maps. The OH-58F shall have level 2 man unmanned, L2 MUM, teaming, the Force Battle Command Brigade and below, FBCB2, display screen, with future improvement to Blue Force Tracker 2. Survivability enhancements include ballistic floor armor and the Common Missile Warning System, CMWS. Other features include improved situational awareness, digital intercockpit communications, Hellfire future upgrades, redesigned wiring harness, health and usage monitoring, HUMS, and enhanced weapons functionality via 1760 digital interface. It has a dual channel, full authority digital engine controller to ensure operations at required power levels in all environments. The OH-58F did not address engine power requirements. Rolls-Royce proposed adaptions of the Model 250 CR-30 engine to increase output by 12%. In October 2012, the first OH-58F was finished. Unlike most military projects, the Army designed and built the new variant itself, which lowered developmental costs. It weighed 3,590 pounds, 53 pounds below the target weight and about 200 pounds lighter than the OH-58D. The weight savings are attributed to more efficient wiring onto lighter sensor. The first production aircraft started being built in January 2013 and was handed over to the Army by the end of the year. Low-rate production was to start in March 2015, with the first operational squadron being fully equipped by 2016. The Army was to buy 368 OH-58FS, with older A, C and D model O-58s to be remanufactured into F models. Because of battle damage and combat attrition, total OH-58F numbers would be about 321 aircraft. The first flight of the OH-58F occurred on April 26, 2013. The Army chose to retire its Kiowa fleet and end the F model CASUP upgrades. CASUP and SLEP upgrades would cost $3 billion and $7 billion respectively, totaling $10 billion for features that the Army cannot afford to allocate money to. The OH-58D can reach 20% of armed aerial scout mission requirements. Upgrading to OH-58F standard would raise that to 50%. Replacing the Kiowa with Apaches and unmanned systems in scout roles would meet 80% off requirements. In the first quarter of 2014, Bell received a stop work order for the Kiowa F model CASUP program. On April 14, 2011, Bell performed the successful first flight of their OH-58F Block 2 variant. The Block 2 was Bell's entry in the Armed Aerial Scout program. It built on the improvements of the F model, and added features including the Honeywell HTS-900 turboshaft engine, the transmission and main rotors of the Bell 407, and the tail and tail rotor of the Bell 427. Bell started voluntary flight demonstrations in October 2012, and the Army had to decide by December if it would even proceed with the AS program. Bell hoped for the Army to go with their service life extension models instead of the program. The F model Kiowa is an obsolescence upgrade, while the Block 2 is seen as the performance upgrade. This gave the Army flexibility in times of shrinking budgets, as they had the option of upgrading the Kiowa to the F model and then continuing to the Block 2 later when there were sufficient funds. Shortly before December 2012, the Army decided they would recommend proceeding with the AS program. The Army ended the AS program in late 2013. With the onset of sequestration budget cuts in early 2013, it was decided that the $16 billion cost of buying new armed Scout helicopters was too expensive. The OH-58X was a modification of the fourth development OH-58D, SN-69-16322, with partial stealth features and a chin-mounted McDonnell Douglas Electronics Systems turret as a night piloting system, including a Kodak flare system with a 30-degree field of view. Avionics systems were consolidated and moved to the nose, making room for a passenger seat in the rear. No aircraft were produced. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.